Wow, today's video is going to be insane. I've never seen something like this in my life. Welcome back, Plug Nation. It's your boy Badge Plug, and today we're gonna get straight into the news. So whatever you gotta do, make sure that like button is blue, hit that subscribe button if you're new, and let's get into the news. So I woke up today and 2K dropped a 50 GB patch on one game, a 9 GB patch on the other, and I was reading it and I couldn't believe what I was seeing. In the new update on 2K22, so far we know walkbacks are now patched. There are now 3 elite spin wheels on current gen. The rebirth build feature returns from 2K19 in a quest, and certain dribble animations have changed. Example, Damian Lillard behind the back is different. So I woke up and I was like, wow, 2K, I can't believe this. We're doing great things. What's going on? This is awesome. I just was in amazement. Wow, 2K did something so great. As you can see, the rebirth, just like in 2K19, gives you 20 badge points, 10 my point meters. So you're gonna start off at like 90 overall. It's not the exact same as 2K19, but one of, if not the best reward in 2K history. People loved the rebirth option in the game. And for some reason, I was too dumb to understand that every time 2K has done something like this in the past, it always comes with something negative. Well, Power posted on Twitter and it said, your height slash weight slash wingspan now affects your badge count. This applies to all rebirth builds and old builds. You may lose slash gain badges on builds you have already maxed as well. Example, shorter wingspan on guards will give more shooting slash playmaking badges, but lose defense plus playmaking. So 2K randomly decided to strip badges from people on 2K22 current gen. As you guys can see, this guy has a slasher that has lost a finishing badge, has lost 8 playmaking badges and 6 defensive badges. Now, he still has those badges on, but if he's to ever change them, he will lose them. So the person that has a hardworking job and barely has enough money to spend, they get on 2K to have fun and escape from reality, has spent their hard-earned money on a build and they no longer have those badges. Do you think that that is fair? No, that's not fair at all. I'm not even mad at my build. I'm mad because I know people don't have the money. They don't have the time to just go in and make another build. You have stripped their badges from their build. Why was this not implemented in the game before it released? Why do we do something like this every single year? But this is way worse than last year. The thing they did last year was kind of good. It was just that people had already made their builds, so you had to make a new one to get lower ball handling if you wanted to have more variety with your build, because they changed the ball handling from 85 to 80 to unlock dribble moves, which was a good thing, like I said, but still should have happened before the game came out. But this year, this is not even close to the same thing. Like, you just, now there's going to be pre-patch builds where if you don't change the badges, that build is going to be so much better if you had it before the patch. And the worst thing out of the entire situation is that if you didn't have those badges grinded out, let's say someone spent their hard-earned money to grind out this build, they were halfway done, well, now they're not even able to earn those glitch badges that you can keep on as long as you don't change them. So you just, and then you just threw in rebirth as an insurance, like, hey, here's something nice. I mean, you can change up your build if you want to. Like, I just don't get it, 2K. But let's look at this build I posted 2 days ago. I did change the finishing around, as you'll see in the next screenshot. But 8 shooting, 21 playmaking, 20 defense. It now has 6 shooting, 16 playmaking, and 18 defensive badges. So in those 3 categories, they removed 9 badges off the build. I can't believe that if I upgraded that build, I would have woke up today so immeasurably disappointed. I can't imagine how upset people are that haven't got to finish out their build yet, and now their build is trash or just not as good as it used to be out of nowhere over a change that 2K should have done before the game even came out. So even people like PowerDF, who we've talked about before, you know, we joke around, oh, he's on the contract with 2K, whatever. But he literally said, how can you make a build spend BC on it, then have a different badge count? That's scamming. And GB said, even more important than the BC is the countless hours it took to max the build just for them to completely change your build out of nowhere. So for Power to call 2K out for scamming, that gives me a lot of respect for him. I can't believe that he did that. I was not expecting that at all. But into this next one though, GB said, if 2K is going to change the build system randomly, there has to be some form of compensation for the builds I made. To me, it makes sense to allow us to recreate the builds we already have, but keep the batch progress and attribute unlocks we have accumulated on the build. So people are very upset, and for good reason. PowerDF, he said, if you have a maxed build with all your badges, you can keep the badges you have, but let's say your build used to have 30 defensive badges, but they decreased it to 27 and you only had 25 unlocked, you can never get to that 30. You're capped at 27 now. So what I was saying before, that if you didn't finish out your build, you're screwed now. You're just out of luck. You don't have those badges at all. And then he even went to say petition for 2K to refund VC on all changed builds, like if you agree. And that's true. 2K needs to compensate us for what they just did today. They need to give people VC for the builds they just messed up. Power said, changing the builds is bad because it makes people who were in the middle of finishing their builds use a build they didn't want to make, but the huge missing part is it also creates a competitive imbalance. Now people have builds that no one else can get. That's crazy. And I just don't get it, 2K. Why? Hank said, so when you make a build now on current gen, you lose badges based on your wingspan and you cannot see how many badges you lose until you make the player. It just is so dumb. So anyway, season 2 is starting tomorrow. Finally, what we were talking about yesterday, we want to see the new rewards, and we talked about the files in the game where people have found mascots and jetpacks and all these rewards that could potentially be in the next seasons. I didn't say it was going to be in season 2, but they're going to be in the game 99% at some point from what we've seen. If you want to see all those rewards, go check out the last video after this. But 2K posted today about season 2, and at level 37, you're going to be getting an Empire suit, double XP tokens, a badge point, and a skeleton mascot. So skeleton mascot is the level 40 reward this season. And the thing they're doing this season is called Build Your Empire. That's what they're doing with season 2. As you can see, here's a picture of the courts that they've posted. They wanted people to see what the courts are going to look like. You know, it's going to be like a fall type theme. There's going to be a park after dark, and everything looks so good today. It looked amazing. And then that. Why couldn't we have just had the good part? What is the reason for this? Why is this not mentioned in anything? It's not mentioned in any of the patch notes. They didn't say a single word about it, but yet it affects the entire community. I don't think it happened on Next Gen, by the way, but those rewards are for both games, just in case you guys are wondering. So, man, I really don't understand. I know I've said that so much in this video, but why? Why would you do that, 2K? That's such a dumb mistake. Who thought about that? Why did that not happen before the game came out? Now you've just created this huge imbalance. People are mad. Their builds can never have their badges changed. People were in the middle of grinding their build, and now they don't have the same badges they thought they were going to have when their build's maxed out. Just bad. Really bad, 2K. And you guys know that I've stayed on the good side of 2K this year for a good reason. I've liked both games. You know, they took my logo last year because I spoke out about how I felt about the game. But this year, I've been on the good side, I guess you could say, of 2K because I've enjoyed the game. Now, of course, there's been issues that I've spoke up about in plenty of the news videos, like the elevator glitch and the parks freezing on Next Gen, all the problems that have happened so far. But for the most part, I've just over and over said that I like the game. And now, oh man, I still like the game, but 2K, you just dug a deep hole for me. Like, I was feeling so great about it, and now you've just like thrown me down. I don't even know. Guys, it's your boy Batchbook. Leave your opinions down below. Drop a like if you haven't yet. Hit that subscribe button if you're new. And I'm out. Peace.